she won, and these people aren't screaming at me. I thought they were originally, but they're not.
No,
why are they
right.
screaming, Jess?
They're screaming for one of the biggest bands on the Big Day Out bill. They were here 2 years ago. They are back for more. This is Queens of the Stone Age live on Channel V with Hanging Tree. Queens of the Stone Age!
Away. Oh, will you turn up this voice a little bit? You probably never heard this song before. That's why we're gonna try.
Are you ready? You ready, peeps? One, two, three, four.
A campfire and some marshmallows and beer.
Heaven smiles above me. What they get here below, but no one knows the gift that you give to me. No one knows.
Thank you.
So Of the Stone Age Live, No One Knows, from their latest album, Songs for the Deaf. You can see them tonight at the Metro, tomorrow night at the Enmore Theatre. That's sold out. Or, of course, be watching this Saturday from 4 o'clock when we bring you The Big Day Out in Sydney, live and exclusive. Please make them welcome Queens of the Stone Age.
I am so flustered after that. I think I'll be sleeping with their album under my pillow. Anyway.
It will make you deaf. Of course, Nick, Josh, Troy, Mark Lanigan on vocals, missing Joey Castillo, who's playing drums for them. He normally plays in Danzig. And in fact, you can see him in this next clip with a stocking on his head. This is Ween. We're going to be chatting to Queens of the Stone Age very shortly. I think this is one of your favourite songs, Chloe.
Push your little daisies and make them come.
Dean and Jean Ween, push the little daisies on what you want. Please make some noise for Queens of the Stone Age. This is What You Want live right around Australia here on Channel V on your Thursday afternoon. Please make them very welcome. Queens of the Stone Age, Josh, Troy and Nick. Mark Lanigan was here before. He sang on the first track, Hangin' Tree, and missing today. In fact, he's down the gym doing some weights. Joey Castillo, who's occasionally in the band Danzig. He's touring with the band at the moment. And I believe he was personally responsible for the PA exploding midway through your set in Auckland. Have you ever had an experience where you've had to do two sets at a show to appease the fans before?
I don't remember that, no. Don't remember that.
Unheard of?
Well, we've blown the PA a bunch of times, but we've never been to New Zealand, so we couldn't let it go that way. We had to play again, you know?
That must have been a big G-up for you. You look pretty pissed off. A G-up is where you swear a lot.
Yeah, I wanted to kill motherfuckers.
There you go. Is that what you mean?
Is that what you meant?
Yeah, you can say whatever you want. I'm wondering, what was the reason for the PA blowing? Is it because you play with old
Josh
gear?
Josh did it.
Oh, it's Josh.
I did that, yeah.
We were covering for him, but it was him.
Because we're loud. That's right.
Fair enough. Now, Joey Castillo is playing drums on this tour. He's replaced Dave Grohl, who recorded on the album. Is there a bit of a Spinal Tap policy in Queens of the Stone Age with drummers? Do you go through a lot of drummers?
Yes.
No, Joey came in and did it, and we needed somebody too, and he's a good friend, so he was looking for a gig and we were looking for a drummer.
How many shows have you done with him before you hit the big day out?
None.
None?
No, I'm just kidding. We did two weeks, 3 weeks, 6 months, 8 months, a year.
A lifetime.
I don't know. What day is it? Where am I?
Today is Thursday, I believe, because I'm sure you noticed Dave Grohl was watching the side of stage, so I was thinking the pressure must have been on for Joey. Dave, they're doing all the moves, waiting for Joey to collapse or something.
Hey, look, there's Dave.
There is Dave Grohl right now. There he is at the back of the crowd. It's the Australian Dave Grohl experience.
I love you, Dave.
I'm sure Dave loves you back too. Now, nudity is something that goes hand in hand with the Queens of the Stone Age set. I believe, in fact, Nick, you were arrested at Rock in Rio for performing in the nude?
It's all lies.
It's all lies. Well, that's what television's about. In fact, when you last toured the Big Day Out in 2001 with Queens, you missed the first two Big Day Outs because you were doing Rock in Rio, and I believe that resulted from the fact that you wanted to see the last Metallica shows. Is that true or...?
No, we wanted to go to Brazil.
We wanted to go to Brazil
and eat seafood and wear G-strings and do all that stuff.
Have you gone nude anywhere else? Is there a chance that we may see you go nude on the Big Day Out?
I get nude every day.
Every day.
Do you want to go nude for these
people right now?
Do you want to see Nick naked? Is that what
Yeah,
you...
basically, yeah. Do you want to get nude now?
No.
Where's Alex? We had a guy tabletop dance. There's Alex. He did some. He got nude before for the music.
Him. That guy is fine ass. I want a piece of that after this show is all wrapped up.
Yeah, because we eat human flesh.
Put him in a bag and put him in the van.
The shy van. That is too easy. Now, we've been talking a bit about dangerous people on the show today. In fact, we had a poll running between George W. Bush, Osama bin Laden, and Russell Crowe, who is, in fact, a New Zealand actor who's been adopted by Australians. Who do you think is the most dangerous person in the world right now?
Dave Grohl.
Yeah, he's causing chaos over there.
Put the gun away, Dave. Put it away.
I would say Mark Lanigan is pretty dangerous. He's up here singing for you.
Yeah. He's bin Laden to me. And he can't take it anymore.
Yeah. You first hooked up with him. You, in fact, replaced an Australian guitarist playing in Screaming Trees. Is that right?
I played in the Screaming Trees for a couple of years, yeah.
I think it was good Kent band. Stedman that had been playing with the band from the Celibate Rifles before you, which is an Australian band, the Celibate Rifles.
I can't hear you.
Their latest album is called Songs for the Deaf. Now we know why.
Get it?
What?
Huh? What? Can you speak up? Chloe is down in the crowd. If you can speak clearly, we might be able to get a couple of questions from our crowd here today.
Okay, I don't know any sign language, but hopefully Erin does. She has a question for the Queens of the Stone Age. What is it?
Are you going to collaborate with PJ Harvey?
Are you going to collaborate with PJ Harvey?
Yeah, I hope to. I do this thing called the Desert Sessions, and hopefully she'll come down there and kick some dirt around.
Nice.
There seems to be a lot of songs on Songs for the Deaf that have come from the Desert Sessions. Is that, you know, a deliberate thing?
Not really. It's sort of a testing ground for beats and bizarrety and stuff like that. You know, if something works really good, then we do it. Thank you, Dave. Was that Dave Grohl?
Yeah, I believe so. What is the one thing people yell out at you the most? Is it your play thumb? You've been burned by my lighter.
We get a lot of yells for Caius and a lot of yells for nudity.
Nudity, yeah. Caius. Yeah. In fact, when you were out here last time, you played the Metro and you finished the show with a Caius song. I hope you all enjoyed the show, which was fucking brilliant. Is that something you would plan to recreate again? Do you ever throw Caius songs into the Queens mix?
Well, now we have three records, and so we have a lot of our own songs to choose from.
So we're going to be doing all Caius songs.
Yeah, so we'll do all Caius instead.
Have you ever heard of an Australian band called The Foves? They wrote a song called Understanding Caius.
Yeah.
Yeah. Chloe, I believe you have another question for the Queens of the Stone Age.
Show us your tits. I mean, I don't know where that came from. Steve-o, you got a question for them.
Yeah, who's your favourite performer on the big day out?
Who is your favourite performer on the big day out?
I would have to say, for me, it's probably PJ Harvey.
I'd say Nick.
Cake?
Thanks, Troy.
Yeah, cake. Yeah. Nick.
Nick.
Who's deaf here?
Nick.
Hey.
His favorite is Nick.
Oh, Nick is your favorite guy on the tour.
I have deaf family, so I'm allowed to do that. What about you, Nick? Who's your favorite performer on the big day? The Murder Dolls. Great call there.
Probably PJ and the Foo Fighters.
Uh-huh. And is PJ a big fan of Queens as well?
No, she hates us.
Yeah. No, that's understandable. It's, you know, just pure noise. Now,
I like Troy.
Nick did some solo shows in the UK where, in fact, they were meant to be solo shows, but Josh, you got up with him. Is that, you know, like a stalking factor? Is this true?
I've been stalking Nick since I was 12 years old. And I'm still stalking him now.
Yeah, I like it. Do you have any stalking fans? Do you have any deranged fans that tour you, follow
yeah,
you?
Josh.
Josh, yeah, me. Yeah.
You got to stop hanging outside my door. You got, you know.
You mean other than you?
On his door, you know.
How?
I know this is.
I had one girl that liked to run up and punch me in the side of the head. I'd be walking.
She hit you in the back that one time.
Yeah.
Wow. Where was she from? Was she an American?
She's from hell.
From hell. Yeah. So that's Mount Druitt. Yeah. Read into that. Now, that's a suburb. Are you going to be doing any sightseeing while you're in Australia? Is there any sights that you have to check out?
Yeah, King's Cross. We've been up and down and side to side.
I fell asleep there last night. Or when I passed out.
We went to, up and down the Gold Coast, and there's a place called Lone Pine where you get to hug koalas. And you touch them and you love them. And that's what we were.
Touching and loving koalas.
We came here for the touching and the loving. You understand?
So what's next? You join the Catholic Church?
Yeah. Boys' pants half off.
With pants half off. Well, look, we'd love to hear more songs from you, but tonight you should go and see them at the Metro Theatre in Sydney, at the Enmore Theatre tomorrow night. Of course, the big day out in Sydney on Saturday. That's sold out. You probably still buy tickets for Sydney, for Melbourne, Adelaide or Perth. Of course, Channel V bringing you the big day out. Is there anyone, you got any more questions for the band? No. They're, look at them, stunned mullets.
They're stunned.
We have a high cultural level here in Australia. Take your pants off. Please make some noise for Queens of the Stone Age.
Cheers.
As we go to this is a request for Queens. It's also the sixth biggest song of the day. It's a boy band out of the UK called Busted. I can't believe you requested this.
Hello.
This is a real turn up for the books. What I Go to School For. Please make some noise, Queens of the Stone Age.